shoes on. I got my rain pants on. I put these on in the middle of the night last night because my bottoms of my pants were kind of frozen. They need warmed up by the fire. Speaking of frozen, this is the only water I have left. It did a pretty good job keeping that. I buried it under a bunch of clothes and stuff over here. I'm gonna have to go down and get more water though. First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get fire going. Probably get a little coffee or something in me, warm me up. It's not real bad. I tell you what, I slept warm, even hot. Sometimes I was hot in this, but there were times where I think this was a hammock or adjustment issue more than it was the under quilt. You know how I have it hung and all that. My feet probably got cold mostly. A lot of times I did figure out how to adjust this a little bit better. These shock cord deals here pulled it up because this was all, my feet was ending up hanging off this. And that was part of it. But for it being like 12 degrees, it was awesome. Because I would have never imagined sleeping in a hammock in 12 degrees without something like that, for sure. It definitely kept me warm, but I'm cold now and I need to get the fire going. Get my fire going. I still get quite a bit of wood left. If I can burn, I'll leave it here. Have some for a gathering or another camp before then, maybe. Go get a morning look at the sun. I don't have a clue what time it is. I think it's like 8 something or 9 in the morning. Down here on this ledge, it'd be sweet. From between that tree and that tree. That'd be nice. Yes, sir. This is the, I guess, probably the best route to get to the water. It's a little bit of a hike compared to that creek that we were next to last year. I don't have to break through frozen water. I didn't even bring anything to break through with. I'll get through with a stick or something. And that new Sawyer filter, they say, you know, if they freeze, that they don't work or some shit like that. Well, I realized this morning that I did not put mine in my sleeping bag or anything, or in the hammock with me. So, of course, it hasn't had water run through it, so maybe it doesn't freeze until it gets wet. We'll find out. We'll see how that goes. Now, usually the water comes up to right there on that, around that log right there. Maybe even a little higher. This is Wolf Creek that runs back this way. No Name Creek that runs back this way. So we're right in the very fork of it. So I had a busty little hole in the water there. Yeah. Hole in the ice to get some water. Actually, I see little baby fishes, it looks like, swimming under there. Anyways, I'm gonna get this water filled up. So my plan last night and today had been to get some squirrel, because this is like, there's only one more weekend left of squirrel hunting. So my plan had been to get a squirrel last night and have a squirrel hobo packet. Try that out. And if I got an extra squirrel or more than one squirrel, I'd planned on attempting of biscuits and squirrel gravy out here. But I forgot my 22 ammo. So I kind of had a plan for backup just in case I did not get a squirrel. Calling that down because I'm hungry. My plan was last night do the red beans and rice and the elk sausage like I did if I didn't get a squirrel. That's what I did. And also the veggie packet, which I didn't even bother with because I wasn't hungry enough for it. And then my plan was to have biscuits and squirrel gravy. Her squirrel gravy is really awesome. And bacon. But since I didn't get a squirrel, my plan was I could make bacon gravy, and my mom used to make that. It's good too. How can it not be? It's bacon. But obviously, I think I'm going to skip the gravy part, and I may, it's such a pain to get water. I mean, I would probably need more water to make all that stuff, so, I may try to do the biscuits. If not the biscuits, probably, I may use a potato and onion that I brought to, cook up some, fried potatoes onions. So, I got one of the two, either some biscuits or probably the potato and onion because they're heavy to carry out. I'm loving the bacon though. I would have put a. I'm just hungry, man. So I went ahead and used the skillet. I like to crane it, but cook it slow. But I'm hungry and I want to get things done. I don't know what time I'm leaving here. I'm pretty hell and warm. It's nice out. One good thing is there's not a whole lot of wind last night and today, so that kind of helped with the temperature situation.
So I was trying the bush box, and you really need something very, very, very level to set it on. I thought the spot that I had was level, but then it melted through some of the icy ground or whatever and started tipping on me, and then it was hot, so I couldn't grab a hold of it to move it anywhere, so I don't feel like starting all over again, so I'm finishing it off, the bacon off in the fire. But other than that, while it was working before it started tilting on me, it seemed to be working pretty damn good. I think that I like it. I'd like to give it, probably wouldn't even focus half that time with it. I'd like to give it more of a try for sure. I mean, I've had another, hang on, let me attend to my bacon. I scorched a little bit of last of it, and that's a blasphemous thing to eat, a bacon. Hang on. Well, guys, I think I'm about to pack up. I'll let this burn out, start packing. After I get everything packed, depending on what time it is, I may do a little pack off scouting, have the weight off my back. It's a pretty good trip for the coldest trip I've ever done. Had a few glitches, leaving some things at home, and melting my Nalgene bottle, and not setting my bush box on something level to try it out, and things froze up, batteries wasn't working quite right, I broke a power cord to charge my phone. I mean, there were some issues on this trip, but I still had fun, and I stayed warm in this hammock gear under quilt and we'll pimp them out. 0 degree hammock gear incubator and hammock gear burrow. I stayed warm. A few cold spots, but again, I think it was an issue with my hang and learning the adjustment deals on this. There's a way to pull it up this way, there's a way to cinch this up and all that, and it's kind of got to get used to it, I guess, but it worked out pretty good. I mean, hell, I didn't freeze to death, so. And I was warmer in it at 12 degrees than I have been before, using pads and stuff at like 40 degrees or something, you know. And again, I can use this top quilt when I'm sleeping on the ground, so, and that top quilt was awesome. Yeah, I'm happy with that. Hey guys, I got my stuff packed up. Just getting ready to go, and I kind of started looking around over here. I noticed this little deal that goes down into that big valley there. I also noticed a lot of these tracks going down through there, and sea tracks going through that way. I don't want to get started on exploring this area down here. I'm going to save that for for the spring meetup. But this looks like a little bit of a runoff here. I wonder if there's any water down in this area. I went for this hill, and really, this hill up to there ain't too bad. That's dry right there. That'd be a hell of a, that would be a hell of an area for the campfire. Whole little enclosed little area right there. But I'm wondering if, because I see what looks like a runoff that runs on down through there. And there's a bunch of springs through here. I'm kind of wondering if there isn't a spring right in here somewhere in this area. There'd really pretty much be no way to tell right now. But I know that there is back in over that way. And, I think you'll be able to see where the springs are at over here, the direction I'm going. Doubt very much there's any water running in them right here. Yeah, and I think that there's probably some like that over in the other one, over in that other side. There's springs down in this little ravine here. There's some water over here even. Yep. A little bit of water trickling. Not very much. But there's water coming out of there. It's running too. And I don't know, I'd almost be certain that there's some of those over in that other valley too. I guess it looks like a good place for a break. I've been on a real long uphill. No Name Creek. I think I'm gonna take a little break, give me something to drink. Somewhere, if I go up that way, somewhere it will cut across to the Midway Trail. Cut across that power line to the Midway Trail. And it'd shave like 2 miles off. But I'm not exactly sure where. So I just came up this crazy steep hill from the trail down there. Looking for a shortcut. I'm guessing I'm pretty close because those are someone else's tracks right in front of me. Looks like come down out of the edge of them woods. Yeah. Walked up around that tree. Interesting. I hope I don't step in poop. Well, I found my shortcut. Pretty much the thinnest part of Midway. If anybody's looking for a shortcut to camp, when you get to the thinnest part of Midway Trail, where there's a field on one side and the power line corridor on the other side, immediately drop to your left down a hill, cross the power line corridor, and then down a hill, and you'll hit the trail. Shave off like a mile and a half or something. Alright, well, this is pretty much the end of the hike, guys. It's not going to be the best video, but it's, like I said, it's my little winter adventure for you. Talk to you guys later. Here's my buddy at the end of the hike. Probably the one that left me footprints. Sharing my elk snack stick with him. There you go. That's all of them. You're a good dog. Yeah. Yeah, you're a good puppy. Yes, you're a good dog. ain't you? That's all I got. All out. I'm all out. Let's back scratch. How about that? Yeah, my dog smells that too. Yeah. There you go. You're a good puppy. You're a good pup. Alright, that's my new body, guys. You're a good dog. I don't know what his name is.